I'm just too generous when it comes to cars. Anyway. Hey, y'all. So, we're in the car again. This time, I'm headed to... Is it one of the best movies of the year? No, it is not one of the best movies. Well, I don't know. That's maybe not fair. It was a great movie in terms of graphics and the color in the movie and like all of the things, all the like adventure and the scenes, fighting scenes. Like it was good for that. Storyline I think was okay too. I didn't know that the storyline was what it was gonna be with the one dude going after, well, okay, this is a spoiler alert, so if you have not seen Avatar, you probably should fast forward this part. But the one dude going after Jake, which we thought was, who we thought was dead, you know what I mean? It's almost like they should have come up with a new villain for the story, because I was a little confused in the beginning too, like whose child is what and how is Grace, you know, I was confused in the beginning. So, but we said we're gonna watch it again, because you know, when you first watch a movie, you don't get all the little pieces and bits, and you see things that you didn't see before or notice before. So we're gonna watch it again. Avatar is like his favorite all-time movie, the first one, so he'll probably be watching it more and more than I will. But as far as, but going back to my original statement, as far as best movies of the year, I don't think I could give it that. Was it better than Wakanda Forever? No. It was not better than Wakanda Forever. And that's on Mary Had a Little Lamb, okay? It was not better than Wakanda Forever. Like, for what it was, for them to take that amount of time to, you know, for what it was, I feel like they could have did that in 2 years. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's normal movie time sequel length, you know? Not 10 years apart. Hey, y'all. So, I probably drove like a good 15 minutes after I told you guys I need to get gas. But, ooh, I have 36 miles. I kind of want to go home. We'll get gas tomorrow. But I finally got my Starbucks, went to Target, made the returns, got some stuff that we needed, and then also I made the Amazon returns. Now I'm on my way back and to get the man. I gotta go and scoop him up, and then we're gonna go mattress shopping. Yay!
Might be
doing good so far?
Yes.
Can I have some water, please?
Water?
I don't know about it, even the glove. I feel my shit. On the side here, you have all your lighting control.
Hey guys, I wanted to give you guys a haul of what I got from the Goodwill. So this is the first item. It's a skirt with like the little split in the front, and just wraps all the way around. This skirt was $9.99, and I love it. And it looks like it was brand new because it still has a tag on it. Still has a tag on it. So this is the brand Great Smoky. Never heard of it, but got the tag on it. So got this. Alright, so the next things that I purchased are, number one, this blazer. I love the blue. This is by Calvin Klein. It was $10.99. Has the gold buttons here. Has the makeshift pockets. And then I also got these shorts. These are from American Eagle. These are mad comfortable. I was worried because, you know, some designers, they just don't make things for curvy bodies. But these, this must be from the curvy line because I know that they have it. But this is American Eagle. These were $5.99. So I love it here. So, yes. And then I got two more pairs of shorts. The other pair of shorts that I got, I cannot fit these. They will not go over my hips. It says it's a size 10, which I should fit because this is a size 10, but this is not going nowhere. So I'm going to probably end up giving these to one of my daughters. But it's a shame because I love how distressed they are. I love them. So I can't wear those. But the last thing I got was this jean jacket. It has no label. It's just a denim jacket. And I love that too. So, got that. Hey guys, so we're in the bathroom. You guys know I have the yellow light in the bathroom. Oop, bring you out. There we go. I'm actually almost done getting ready, but it's actually very late in the day. Not very late, it's like 1:30. Technically, I did get up this morning. I did get up and I had work, so I did do that. I did actually go to work, but I didn't get ready. I just got up, literally put on a robe and washed my face. You know, they could see the top portion. You know what I'm saying? Literally, I did that. That's just how I was feeling. And you know what? It is what it is. I don't care. That's just how I was feeling. And I get off at 12. So I took lunch, took my break, my first break of the day. And then I said, you know what, let me get up because I'm in a mood. I'm in a little bit of a mood. And I was like, you know what, let me get up. Let me take a shower, you know, freshen up or whatever. And, you know, make myself feel better, put on a little bit of makeup. Just make myself feel better. So, like I said, I'm almost done doing that. But yeah, so I've kind of, like I said, I've been in the mood. I have some things on my mind. And it's kind of been consuming me this entire weekend. Some changes that need to happen. In my current career. So that is kind of what I have been kind of focused on. It's not a decision that I need to make hastily, so you know, I'm definitely taking my time with it. Where is my mess?
I'm definitely taking my time with it. I can't find the mascara that I used the other day, but that's okay. I need to do a lip scrub. I can't find the mascara that I had. It's by It Cosmetics. It was a superhero one. And I had it for, actually, I had it for a while and just decided that I wanted to use it. I don't know where it's at, so I'll just use this one. This is the one by Thrive Cosmetics. This is their Liquid Lash Extensions one, which I love this one too. This one really stays on your lashes though. Like, I have to use mad cleansing oil to get off all of the little extensions. Like, it leaves, you know, it gives like the little extension, so it gives the little pieces on your eyes. But anyway, guys, so yeah, so I took a shower, like I said, took a shower, kind of freshened my hair, threw on some makeup, and I'm gonna spray some perfume. I think I want to go to a coffee shop. They have like a patio area in the coffee shop. In the back, they have a back patio area at the coffee shop. So I think I want to do that. I'm just watching Octavia B. You know, these young girls, man, sometimes I'll be laughing at them because, you know, they think they live so much life. You know what I mean? Like, they think that they have lived so much life and they know so much. And I guess they, you know, they know what they know for their age. So I'm not trying to, you know, down them or nothing. But it's just sometimes it's a little bit of funny. Like, but I mean, I know that they're appealing to a younger demographic. But I watch them so I can, you know, learn little tips and stuff. You can always learn something from somebody. It doesn't matter how old, how young they are. You can always learn something from somebody. So I definitely take, I definitely give them their kudos. I mean, she's got tons of followers and subscribers. So there's definitely something to be learned there. I think I'm gonna leave that clip in my hair a little bit longer. It's just kind of in my way and all of that. But so yeah, guys, so it's actually I'm getting ready to get ready. So yeah, so I'm getting ready to do that. I may also do some reels because I am dressed and my face is ready, and who's to say that on Friday I'm gonna want to do this, because Friday is normally the day that I scheduled myself to do reels and to do content and stuff like that. But I think today I can probably get some content, me working at the coffee shop, you know, doing what I do. Maybe not necessarily talking reels per se, but I can at least do that reel. That's at least one reel. And if I feel up to it, I'll do like a talking one about a topic or something. Yeah, maybe I'll do one in the car. I might do one in the car. We'll see. We'll see how I feel. I have to really be in the mood to do reels. Because that's where that energy comes from. That's where that little spark, that different side of me that comes out when I'm in the mood. I keep trying to force to do reels. You should never try to force to do content if you're not ready. I mean, sometimes I know that if you have like a sponsorship or a job or something, you have no choice. But so this is how my makeup turned out. It looks, you know, looks good. Look a little dark right there. I don't know if that's a shadow or what, but what's on that? It's the same on that side too. I don't know if that's a camera. Can you guys tell that? I don't know. So just simple. And when you look good, people treat you differently. So you guys remember that, especially if you're a brown girl. When you look good, you look presentable, people treat you differently. So it's unfortunate, but it's true. All right, y'all. I'm going to see you guys at the coffee shop. So, okay, guys, before I head out, give you guys an outfit of the day. So I'm wearing the top. This top is from Target. It's a mock neck t-shirt. Now, they had another one similar to this, but this fabric is better. I like it. It's more, I think it's better quality. I'm also wearing these shorts. These are the shorts that I got from the, that I got through Thrifting. And I said that they were Abercrombie. They are not Abercrombie. They are American Outfitters. Is that what it is? No, not American Outfitters. American Eagle. That's what these are. American Eagle. And they're so comfortable. This is their curvy fit line. So they are so comfortable. I'm wearing my sandals. These are from Miss Lola. And then I'm just wearing gold jewelry. This is the dupe of the Van Cleef. I'm wearing some earrings here. I'm not wearing anything on my neck because I feel like that's enough. I need to make sure I take this clip out of my hair before I go. I'm probably going to take it out now. That way it won't be in my face and my hair is going to air dry. But yeah, that is what I'm looking like. So I'll see you guys at the coffee shop. This bag is this crossbody bag is from Base. And I love it. It's just so cute. It holds so much stuff in here. And then I'm bringing my Heavy On Protecting My Peace bag. So I'm bringing that with me. I almost bought the Marc Jacobs. I almost bought the Marc Jacobs tote. Why am I so close? I almost bought the Marc Jacobs tote. I'm not going to lie. You know, I still really like it and I still want to get it. And then I was like, you know, if I want to get it, I should be able to get it. Like, don't not do something based on someone else's opinion. Okay? Welcome back to another weekly vlog where I take you through my week. It is Easter Sunday, so happy Easter to everybody. If you don't believe in Easter, happy Sunday to you. Thank you guys for tuning in. So it's a little bit later on in the afternoon where I'm starting this vlog. I did a great workout this morning. I had a really great workout this morning. I did glutes. Probably a little bit of legs, but mostly glutes, core, and abs is what I focused on this morning. And then I had some breakfast. I had some fruit. I'm drinking my protein shake still. Had fruit, green juice, And then I showered and everything, did my hair. My hair is currently air drying, which is why it looks a little cray cray. And I have it clipped here as well because it's so long. It's so long and I'm trying to create, it's getting harder to shape the fro. My hair is changing because it's growing longer. So yeah, that's why I have it clipped. Just put these little clips in it because, like I said, it's long. Errands wise, I was going to go to Trader Joe's, but now that I think about it, it's Sunday and they might be closed, but I'm gonna check on that. But not that it's Sunday that it's closed, but it's Easter Sunday and they might be closed or have different times or something. So because I want to get some eucalyptus and I want to get some more flowers for the house, I haven't been able to go to Trader Joe's, so I went to Whole Foods instead, and it's just, the flowers are just not the same, the selection is just not the same, the price is not the same. It's a little bit gloomy today, so I hope you guys are okay with the lighting. And I even have my lamp on. That's how gloomy it is. But let's talk about what is going to transpire this week. There's another phone update. If you guys own an Apple, there is another phone update. Okay, let's focus. So this week today we are supposed to go to Trader Joe's. Like I just said, we may or may not go. And then this week, tomorrow, we have a visit to Apple because I have a phone issue. So we're going to be doing that tomorrow. Tuesday, we have a lunch meeting and a Brazilian wax. Wednesday, we have a social media class. And I also want to share with you guys my updated night routine, which I may or may not put that in a separate video, but we'll see. Thursday's going to be like an office work day, but I want to work at actually the college around here. I want to go and work there. Friday, I'm going to be sharing with you guys a little bit behind the scenes. I have a call to do my first professional photo shoot that I'm actually investing in my business and paying money for instead of trying to find a cheap way to do it. Even though they're, you know, don't get me wrong, I love my affordable ways to do it. Honestly, I can take photos of myself, but I'm really trying to make my business shine and do some things. I'm really trying to elevate my business. Saturday, we have a bridal try-on. I got my bridesmaid's dress, so I'm going to be going to David's Bridal to get to try that on and to maybe get some alterations. We also have door knocking on Saturday, which is not confirmed, but we may do that. A little bit of shopping. So that is a plan for this week. So let me go ahead and show you guys the small little home updates that I've done. So we're gonna start in the bedroom. So the first updates I have are is over the bedroom. So if you guys remember, I had mirrors that used to be here over the lamp, you know, when that was the whole craze, and it might still be, but I ended up getting rid of those mirrors because I wanted a standalone mirror for the room. So this mirror was in the living room. I took it, put it in here. So now we have this situation here. So the photos that I once had of my honey and I, they were over the bed. This picture that I created, I updated it, and I added some more plaster to it. And, you know, so it's like my own creation, added it to go on top of the bed. And then I added, it was looking really naked. When I took those mirrors down, it was looking really naked. So I added the pictures of us back. And so those are there. And then I just think it just looks nice now. I was trying to figure out what to do and, you know, was contemplating spending more money. And a lot of times you just have to shop your house. So, or reuse items in your house. So I did this and I like the way it looks. It looks nice and simple and clean and adult. I still may or may not get a cover for the headboard, but right now I think it looks fine. And I still am in search of nightstands, so I will be replacing the nightstands. For over here, I also made a few changes. I had the other four pictures that I had over the bed, I added them here, And it's a little, this one's a little bit covered. But you just have the four pictures here now. And so when I'm looking at this space now, it just looks a lot better. Obviously, without this pile of papers. But yeah, so this is this now. Took the calendar down, kind of put it on the desk there. And then I just have the pictures and everything else that I had here before. So yeah, so that is what I've done in the bedroom. And then I'm gonna take you guys to the garage really quickly because we have a big update in there. If you've been following me on social media, or if you follow me on Instagram, then you know already. So we purchased a gym, an actual squat rack gym situation. This is what I worked out with this morning. So I came in here, did a great workout, and I love it because we have flexibility now. We still have our gym memberships, but which we do go like once or twice a week still, because the gym still, you know, just to kind of have, number one, a change of scenery for us to be able to utilize some of the other machines that we do like to use to, you know, do the sauna. So we still do the gym, but we're not dependent on the gym. Now we can come out here. It really is a matter of convenience, and also no excuses for us to get out here and do a workout. If you're interested in purchasing this gym, I'll leave the link down below for where we purchased this. But yeah, so we got the whole squat rack. We got everything. I can do almost everything on this piece here. So we love this. We took a trip, now we on your block, and it's like a doing all this and all that. Doing all this and all that. I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Where did these niggas be at when they said it close down? Doing all this and all that. We took a trip, now we on your block, and it's like a doing all this and all that. Doing all this and all that. I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Where did these niggas be at when they said it close down? To the trip, now we on your block, and it's like a doing all this and all that. Doing all this and all that. I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Where did these niggas be at when they said it goes down? Doing all this and all that. We took a trip, now we on your block, and it's like a doing all this and all that. Doing all this and all that. I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Where did these niggas be at when they said it goes down? Doing all this and all that. We took a trip, now we on your block, and it's like a doing all this and all that. Doing all this and all that. I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Where did these niggas be at when they said it goes down? Doing all this and all that. We took a trip, now we on your block, and it's like a doing all this and all that. Doing all this and all that. To the trip, now we on your block, and it's like a doing all this and all that. Doing all this and all that. I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Doing all this and all that. We took a trip, now we on your block, and it's like a doing all this and all that. Doing all this and all that. I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Doing all this and all that. We took a trip, now we on your block, and it's like a doing all this and all that. Doing all this and all that. I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down. Yeah, know they be lying 100%. Moved out of the risk, but got by the bed. Now they just call me, cause time ain't gon' get it. Now that boy off and I don't wanna quit it. If it was me, they wouldn't regret it. Let me be dead, and now they won't get it. Yeah.
See, I'm just gonna keep it G with you, baby. When you call me talking about where I'm at, I'ma tell you where you ain't.
That's where I'm at.
Slow, so. She keep her heels on high, jeans on tight, pretty in the face, so the makeup on light. Got my eyes on you, and yours on me. My body language saying, shorty, what it's gonna be. Yours look like it's saying, they can tell me. It's fuck that nigga, what you tryna tell me? Cause you walked in with your boo and we was like, aw. Don't matter me, cause you're leaving with moi. You know I hate his talk, better send me a text. You keep playing with her, yeah. ex gon' be my next. And if you quit claiming, you could get a friend pass like Bismarck, which is just a friend pass.
Me and B, I see you do a thing. Might wanna rap, but she'll make you sing. I was on her, she was on him. She all up on my thing, and my thing on her hip. She ATL pop, don't know how to act. She left for one song and came right back. Grinding on me the rest of the night. A man started mugging, he can see it in my eyes. Little mama so rude, little mama say fly. White feet her with the denim.
Hey guys, see what I mean about is long? Anyway, I am off work now. Yeah, hair is like crazy. I am off work now and I am currently on the chat with Spectrum. They jacked up my, I was getting their mobile service, right? Because Verizon, let's just be real, Verizon charges hella money for their service, which is the same as Spectrum, especially since Spectrum is using their towers, is leasing their towers or whatever. Like, Verizon is not premium service and Spectrum is the same, so there's no difference. So you know me, I'm trying to save some money, you know. I switched over, ported my first line, no problems. The second line, which is really Verizon's fault, the foundation of this is Verizon's fault, but now it's becoming a Spectrum issue because they are not fixing the problem. They are, you know, putting in these mystery tickets, coming to find out that these tickets were never submitted. Let me start this over. So Verizon locked my daughter's line, the phone. It was unlocked previously, but when they saw that I ported out, they locked the second line. So I had to call them, have them unlock it. They gave me some account. They told me to use the account number and my account PIN in order to port over the second line. So I did that with Spectrum. The person that I was speaking to, because it was still saying locked on the Spectrum side, the person that I was speaking to in Spectrum, hold on, she's typing. He messed up the numbers. He deleted my phone number, ported in the second number, and put it on my line, which is my daughter's number. So he basically erased. So when he ported in my daughter's line, he erased my phone number and put her number on my line. Okay, and then gave my daughter some other ugly number, some 689 number. And so I've basically been, so because of that, he effed it up. He like gets off the line. You know how they act like they didn't hear from you, so they close out the chat. He did that. And so I'd spoken to another person, the mobile repair department. And hopefully this can be fixed because it's looking like she's might be able to fix it. And she supposedly put in a ticket. She never put in a ticket. And so I went the whole weekend without having like a regular phone service. Like I could get FaceTime calls and I could do WhatsApp if you had WhatsApp. You know, I could surf the internet and I could do iMessage and stuff with Wi-Fi only. But basically, I can only call 911 on my regular line because the phone was technically not on the network. And the reason it wasn't on a network is because if I had activated my line, then it would have been her phone number. And I don't want her phone number. I want my phone number. So I chose to wait for them to fix this because it was supposed to, she put in the ticket. So I chose to wait for her to fix this. It's now Monday. And here I am on the thing with this rep. So hopefully this can get resolved. And then, like, I need to do things. I gotta go to Apple today. My kitten is all over the place. She's everywhere. She doesn't feel well. She don't feel well. Yeah, I don't feel well. And I need to be able to make an appointment for her. And I have, like, personal stuff that I need to get done that I need a working phone number for. I mean, you guys understand that. So, my lips chat. Anyway, such is life. Hey, guys. So, it is Tuesday. And I am headed out to my first meeting of the day. I'm meeting a fellow real estate agent to just kind of discuss some things. So we're gonna just chat for probably about a good hour, and then after that I have a Brazilian appointment scheduled. I'm past due, so I think last time I shared this, I was past due. They keep changing my technicians because they keep leaving, so it's like I get a different technician, and which is frustrating. But I already prepaid two packages or three packages, and I have two left, so I'm gonna continue to use up those packages until they're done. And I may or may not change places. I've been kind of considering trying to sugar at home, but it's just not possible. Like, it's hard to get in all the nooks and crannies, you know what I'm saying? So I probably will still go and seek some places, but I'm sure there's some other sugaring places out there. I've been going to the same one for about 2 years now, but again, they keep changing my technicians, so I'm just... And I keep saying technicians. I don't know if that's what they are, but they keep changing them. So that's just getting to be frustrating. So, yeah. So I am, that's why I'm all kind of dressed up. It's like sunny / dreary out here, which is why I'm kind of wearing sunglasses. But then probably we'll take them off later because, yeah. It's just like, why are we kumbayaing? Like, y'all don't want to go? The way people drive baffles me. Anyway, so I got some Amazon stuff in too. I got the curtains that, I want to say that I think I purchased this curtain before. This was maybe the first fabric curtain that I got. It's because it's really, really thin. It's like sheet thin. It's really, really thin, and it's supposed to be water resistant, not waterproof, but water resistant, and you know, all the good things. And it's washable. I prefer fabric curtains over, like, even the liner. I prefer them over plastic. I just feel like you're gonna have to clean them anyway, so it's easier to clean. You just throw them right in the wash machine, and then you just sanitize and clean your wash machine, you know, every month. You should be doing that anyway. And as opposed to a plastic one where you have to clean it, or you spray it with bleach or whatever, and then it, after a certain point, it just becomes real nasty and you have to throw it away, and then you have to buy a new one. So I probably, right now, my fabric shower curtains, I probably replace those once a year, as opposed to every couple of months replacing a plastic one. Hold on, y'all. There's a po-po behind me I gotta keep an eye on, because I don't think you're supposed to be recording yourself in the car, but I'm doing it. And I need to get by this truck. Like riding extra trucks anyway. So yeah, so that is what the plan is for today. Actually, no, let me go back. Uh-oh, he's coming. Let me stop. Hey y'all, this is what I'm wearing to dinner. I was gonna wear a dress, but I decided to just wear this. So I'm wearing these. These are from Aldo. These, they're like an ombre heel. And then I have on these Fashion Nova jeans, which Fashion Nova, you know, they make good jeans. You know, some of their other stuff is not that great of quality, but they make pretty decent jeans. And then this turtleneck, because it's kind of dreary, windy, and cooler today. This turtleneck from Shein. And y'all know the restaurants be cold as hell. So, and I don't want to wear a jacket. But yeah, this is a better view. So, these are the shoes. Like I said, they're like an ombre nude heel with the jeans from Fashion Nova. And the turtleneck, and then gold jewelry. No, my daughter is 22. Wow, I remember I had her at 21, so for her to be now 22, it's just like pretty crazy. But I'm just gonna wear a gloss. Keep It Simple is gonna come off anyway, because we're going to the Cheesecake Factory. That's where she wanted to go. And I haven't been to Cheesecake Factory in like, I can't remember the last time I've been, but it's been a minute since we went to Cheesecake Factory. So, we'll see you guys at the restaurant.
Birthday to you.
Cha, cha, cha.
Birthday to you. Happy
moment. I don't know where it's coming from though, that's the thing.
going fast enough for you. I'm headed to Costco. Today is the first day of my fruit fast, in case you guys didn't know. I don't know if I mentioned it on here, where I'm going to be just doing all fruit for 21 days. So fruit and water all 21 days. And no, that's not the reason why I'm bitchy. I actually don't even really know why I'm bitchy. But y'all, I am. I'm headed to Costco because I need to read up on fruit. And they have some of the fruits, like they have it in bulk, that we will be eating or that we like to eat. And then I have to go to Publix or maybe Winn-Dixie to get some berries and stuff. And then tomorrow I want to go to a farmer's market and see if I can get some more, like, better organic produce as well. And we're just doing fruits, no vegetables, no caffeine, no any of that other stuff. It's just fruit and water, like I said. So and yeah, so it's a simple fast. The directions are simple if you're interested in trying something like that. You might be asking, why am I doing 21 days as opposed to starting off with a shorter amount of days? And that is because you can't really see the effects of a fast in like 3 days. Like, you might feel something, but for it to have a vast overall improvement, you want to do it, I would say, at least 7 days. Like, if you want to try a fast, try it for 7 days. This isn't my first one, and so it's my first one of this type of fast. And this is actually, it should be an easier fast because I still am eating. I'm just eating fruit, but, you know, not in the way of you're not eating any food whatsoever. You're still eating fruit. You're still eating food, solid foods. It's just fruit, as opposed to just juicing for 7 days and not having any type of food whatsoever. Now, that to me, I feel like it's the ultimate cleanse. That's the first ever cleanse that I did. I did that for 7 days. I lost 13 pounds. Hardest thing I ever did in my life, but I did it. Yeah, so I'll see you guys at Costco.